Hey, what's happening, guys? I'm Stereotype Gamer, and welcome back to Doctor Who Legacy. As promised last week, we will be looking at Grace Holloway when she was fully maxed, which I didn't bother to do in the last one. Also, be checking out a brand new companion who's just arrived exclusively to Google Play, which I'll show as well. And we'll also be doing the fan area and talking all latest news of Doctor Who Legacy. I'll also be showing off a costume that you may have missed unless you attended the Adipose TV. So let's go and check out what's new in the TARDIS. So as promised, I'll show off what Grace looks like. Stat-wise, which is max level, which she actually isn't. Let's just quickly do that. Obviously, I had something left to do. Now, as you remember, she is a healer character. Yep, hold back death in 14 turns, heal allies for 100% of max HP. So she just completely fills up your life again, regardless of how much life you do have. You just get 100%. 250. Best going back a bit, aren't we? To get the added one. 2740 HP. 2749 attack. Plus an additional 274 attack, too. So, not bad for the healer. What else are we going to be showing? I will be showing this exclusive costume that if you attend to the Adipose TV, you will have. If not, you've missed out. Where were you? And it's the new Pixel Captain Jack Harkness in his... The Empty Child. I was trying to remember the name of the episode. The Empty Child costume. And I'm obviously still missing the Pixel costume as well. Talk a bit more about the Pixel stuff in a minute. I've got a new companion to show. It was exclusive to Google Play, and it's Susan Foreman, and she is, I say, exclusive entirely to Google Play for the next 60 days. Obviously, if you've got a Google Play, the code will pop up when you open up the game, so you can claim her. If not, I'll just put the code at the end of this video for you guys to go and check out. Select the gem and change that colour to blue. The ability is more along the line of like Sonic Screwdriver. Wait, does it actually look like Harlan Ford? So let's get into the fan area. We'll do the fan area level and we'll talk what's new and upcoming for Doctor Who Legacy. I'll just take me. It's the black team. Yeah. Take a man of black team. Fucking messed that up. So, new to Doctor Who Legacy, the team's getting ready for the launch of Bigger on the Inside Chapter 1. For those who don't know, Bigger on the Inside is a, I suppose, spin-off story is probably the better word. Kind of deviates from the current main story of the Master. And deals with a brand new monster, something that we've not seen before. Is entirely unique from Tiny Rebels, Doctor Legacy. That's the kind of professionalism you get in these videos. If you forget the game, you even play it. And Bigger on the Inside is also where the Pixel costumes, designed by Pixel Who. I'll have to mentally leave links for them as well, so you can go and check out their artwork. They make all the Pixel costumes, as you saw with the Captain Jack Harkness costume. And the story to Bigger on the Inside is being written by George Mann, alongside with Lee Cummings. George Mann is best known for writing Engines of War, the War Doctor story, also Eighth Doctor's Titan comics. That's not much more I can do here. So yeah, keep an eye out for Doctor Who Legacy, Bigger on the Inside, Chapter 1, coming to the end of the month, I believe, was the release date, July 27th. Don't quote me to that one, because I'm not 100%. Best way to find out news, really, about Doctor Legacy is go and follow them on Facebook, Twitter, and also subscribe to their weekly newsletter, where not only you can get first time information, best place to get it. But also receive the occasional exclusive codes for those who subscribe to the newsletter. know what I might do actually while I'm here and talking about Pixel Hill? I might actually go and play the first few levels of it. With the prologue. Which is essentially a taster of bigger on the inside. And it's free to play anyway, the prologue. I was actually hoping to be able to get the next round without any other bloody luck gems. Now the six doctors are no longer stunned, let's do this. Oh, that's right, yeah. Oops. Nice little haul of goodies. Right, let's change the gem skins while we're here. Will there be any more added? No, still doesn't remember. Here we go. A lonely TT capsule type 40 Mark III TARDIS sits in the time vortex, gently spinning in the silence of infinity. As time collapses around them, the 13 incarnations of the Doctor and dozens of his most faithful, determined allies find themselves having a rare moment to catch their breath. In the distance, too quick and too small to be picked up by the early warning protocols, a thin glowing lance of metal shoots towards the TARDIS at inhuman speeds. Their moment of silence is about to be shattered by an old acquaintance. So go on then, ask me. No. Go on, this is fun, admit it. This isn't remotely fun. Go on, ask me. Ask me how I would deal with a royal beast or pedalon while in a... Where this time? Is this the only way you can relax while the TARDIS refuels? In a garlic factory. Yours is almost as bad as mine. Leave them be, it's good to be prepared. You never know what could be round the next. The Eighth Doctor senses something and looks over at the central console. A lifetime of connection to the psychic circuits of the TARDIS, a sixth sense. He's not alone. A second later, the console is crowded with his incarnations. There's something on the scanner, but it's travelling far too fast. Possibly some sort of controlled, super-reluctant emission. Battlestick! Damage! Please tell me you were about to scream battle stations. This is no time for... Well, yes it was. But you're never to speak of that again. I expect it to be more... gallant. Useful. Everyone up now, let's see what the... The central console sparks and screams. Damage is light. Do this level and then we think we'll call it quits. A silence fills the console room, the doctors are in shock, and the collected allies look to the doctors for some hint of what they should be doing. A beat, then the cloister bell starts to ring out. Filling the console room with sound, the Fourth Doctor dives towards a set of controls. Enough of that. I think we're all aware there's a problem. The cloister bell fades. Astounding. I've never seen anything like this. Neither have I. Which is far more terrifying. The Tenth Doctor scans the spike with his sonic screwdriver. Amazing, I've never thought I'd see a dwarf star alloy again, especially in this quantity. and it interlaced with some sort of circuitry it's trying to communicate with the TARDIS. Suddenly, there's a sound, almost a scream, metal on metal. The TARDIS shakes violently. It's not trying to communicate with them. It's forcing code into a databank and virus of some kind. The TARDIS shakes again and cooling gas starts to leak into the control room. It's attacking her systems, forcing her coolant leak to poison us. In a few minutes there won't be any oxygen left in here. So this beginning section, the prologue section, wasn't actually written by George Mann. He actually came on board to write the story after this segment was written. I believe this was just the hand of Lee Cunning, who is one of the lead of Tiny Rebel, along with his wife Susan. What we know of the story so far is that it's going to be very heavily based around the Ape Van War Doctor, which isn't surprising when it's George Mann because he does actually seem to enjoy writing them too. Thank you. I'm back. So as I was saying before I was rudely interrupted, if you want to see more of Doctor Who Legacy's Bigger on the Inside story, go and download the game, check out the Blue Cells. I can't be bothered doing it all again. But no, it is a worthwhile thing to go download. It's free to play the game. Of course, it's in app purchases and stuff, adverts, but you can purchase the fan area and unlock the ability to block adverts. So, if you guys like this video, leave a like, leave a comment, let me know what you think of the video, and remember to share this video. Please remember to subscribe to Stereotype Gamer, as always, the support for the channel really does help. All like, comments, and subscriptions do go an awful long way, especially your shares, because more people share this too. The bigger and better community we possibly build here at the Stereotype Gamer channel. Thanks again, guys, so much for watching this video, and I shall see you guys in the next video. And also, go and check out Tiny Rebel, Doctor Who Legacy, on Twitter, Facebook, and etc. All links in the description below. Also, check out The Adipose TV on Twitch and all stuff. I'll leave links for him as well. Also, check out Pixel Who. I'll have to add links for them. I don't think I have anything to link for George Mann, but go and check out some of his stuff as well. You can get his stuff from Titan Comics. Also, go and buy Engines of War book. That's a brilliant read, by the way, The Engines of War. I think that's it for the plugins. Bye!